Well, everybody is guaranteed by both constitutions their day in court to face their accusers in court before life, liberty, or property can be removed from them. What's happening is the IRS is relying on fear and intimidation for the counties to certify, record, and file their notices of federal tax liens. And that's not just the IRS. It's any type of a claim of lien that comes in from attorneys or anybody. You must have had your day in court. There must be an order, warrant of distraint, or judgment from a court accompanying any lien.
And it has to be attached to the lien?
It has to be attached to the lien. It's part of what's called perfecting the lien.
It has to be certified by somebody?
It's got to come from a court of competent jurisdiction, that you've been in front of the court, you've been found liable for, therefore you owe the debt.
And is that happening here?
Absolutely, it is not happening here. What's happening is these notices of federal tax lien are being electronically sent to the recorders. The recorders are then date stamping them with their seal, filing them and recording them. That turns it into a security that the IRS can come back and get a copy of, take it to the sheriff. The sheriff can confiscate it and sell it because it's a certified document.
So they just skipped the judicial process, and that's why there's no due process. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, sir. That's exactly what's happening.
Does that sound constitutional to you?
It's absolutely unconstitutional.
And so what have you done about it?
Well, what we did is we took 7 months to combine all of the documented evidence. We put it into a book, 126, 27-page book. We presented it to the county commissioners on August 8th of 2007 and subsequent meetings with them since to try to move them to accept an ordinance to stop the fraud that's going on. And we wrote the ordinance as well.
Ray, is that what happened?
Yeah, absolutely. We had several special meetings with the county commissioners regarding this issue. We presented our evidence. It was never refuted in any of those meetings. The interesting thing about it is that they weren't actual commissioners' court meetings. Since they were special meetings, they were able to do things that they wouldn't normally be able to do. However, it is all on record. It is all on DVD. You can view them either at our website at theliberators11.org, or you can view them on the county's website, too. And Loma's right, it is a due process issue, and I want to reiterate that it's not a tax issue. We have a lot of liens coming from mortgage companies, which are not valid liens because they do not hold the original note or the mortgage to the property. We have liens coming in from attorneys on private debts that have not been perfected and from other private entities. And our due process rights are being violated. You know, the Constitution says that we should be able to be secure in our persons, papers, effects, and property. And today we're not.
Did she say that right, Loma?
Yes, she did say that right.
So what you're telling me is an attorney, the IRS, other entities can simply fax in or email a lien on somebody's property, make a claim that they have a right to it, if I understand you right, and then without any court hearing, without any evidence presented in front of a jury and a judge, they start proceedings with the sheriff to kick people off their own property and take their home and property. Is that what's happening in Douglas County?
It's happening across the country. It's not just Douglas County. This is standard practice in every county in the nation.
And if you ask a lawyer and ask him if it's legal, what do you think a lawyer would say?
Well, basically the answers from the attorneys are that, yes, it's legal. The IRS is a different kind of judgment creditor, is what their special attorney said in our meeting. But she never did specify just what kind of judgment creditor and where they got the authority. She couldn't answer that question. And it clearly states in their own codes, in the IRS code, exactly what they're supposed to do to perfect that loan or that lien. Now, remember, it's not a lien. It's a notice of, okay? And until it is perfected, it does not become a lien. The only thing that it is once the recorder stamps it is it becomes a negotiable security. And that's when they step in and take that negotiable security and enforce it by seizing and selling the property. When that property is sold, there's no deed that's attached to it other than a quitclaim deed. The deed has not been perfected. The IRS has not gone to court to take possession, legal possession of the property.
And see, and the clerks know exactly what they're doing. Our clerk here knows exactly what she's doing. When in my campaign this past primary, at the Drain Forum, one of the people that asked her a question was, if I wanted to file a lien, what do I have to have? And she made it very clear to him, as an individual, he had to have a judgment. And yet she's allowing her seal and her signature on notices and claims of liens and filing them into the record, relying on the state and the counties protecting her. But she is liable. Any clerk that does this is liable personally.